They're in the business to make money, and unfortunately, a lot of their money now is going back to terrorists. The emerging threats.
Derek Maltz was a special agent in the United States Department of Justice. In 2007, he established the Counter Narco-Terrorism Operations Center.
Chapo Guzman was one of Forbes' wealthiest individuals in the world, right? It's about making money. Of course they do research. They study what law enforcement is doing. They don't want to go to jail, so they look at how they can beat the system. They have no bureaucracy, right? They have no budget constraints. They have no policies. They don't have any real processes like we do in law enforcement to follow. So they're about making money, and they're going to do whatever they have to do to make money. Drugs aside a second, they're charging like $3,000 to $10,000, according to the DHS secretary. They're charging $3,000 to $10,000 to bring these people in. They're making $500 million a year just in human smuggling, right, on the border. A lot of these people are probably coming in on the tunnels. It's not just the drugs, right? And God only knows what type of people they're smuggling in, because they don't really care. They're just about making money. So, you know, you have, Middle Easterners that are flying into Central America, flying into Venezuela, getting into Mexico, going through the tunnels, and next thing you know, we have them all over our country. This is not a national health issue we're talking about. It's a national security issue. If you look at just Hezbollah alone and their emergence into cocaine trafficking in the ton quantities, and a few years ago, under Project Cassandra, one individual was indicted in Virginia for moving $200 million a month through this trade-based money laundering ring to support Hezbollah. And this individual indicted for moving the proceeds of 85,000 kilograms of Los Zetas cocaine. So we're talking about huge business. Most murders in the history of Mexico, May of 2018. Last year, 29,000 people were killed in Mexico. The violence is escalating through the roof. If you look at some of the spillover violence, now, the U.S. government was very cute over the years in defining what spillover violence meant, right? So they used to say, we're not seeing spillover violence, because spillover violence was defined as deliberate attacks against U.S. people, interests, and property. So we really didn't see that, honestly. But what we did see is people getting burned down to a crisp in the middle of Detroit, or we saw people being shot in the head or sliced up in apartments or electrocuted with jumper cables on their ears, okay? We saw kidnappings, home invasions all over America, and it's still going on. And the gang activity.